Hi guys, welcome to another Divi Theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we've got some fun button animations for you today. If I refresh this page one more time, you'll see this one bounce up and down several times. You'll see this one pulse several times. And as you can see, this one's floating right here. If I put my mouse on it, it'll stop. Let's just refresh. Really easy to do. As usual, I've pre-written some CSS code for this today, so all you need to do is copy and paste it. It'll be down below this video. And I'll walk you through these and show you how to do this. So let's get started. If we look over to the left here, and this is where you need to paste your code, if you want to use it, in your additional CSS panel. For anybody who doesn't know how to get here, go down to your dashboard. Once at the dashboard, go to Appearance and customize. That'll take us to this page here. Right at the bottom, you'll find additional CSS. I've temporarily got my page set as the home page in the home page settings here. You don't need to do that. The other option, you can also paste this code. If we go back to the dashboard, you can go down to Divi theme options. Under the general tab, if you slide down to the bottom, you've got a custom CSS panel. You can paste it in here also. It's the same thing as the additional CSS. Great. Well, let's get started. I've just got three regular buttons here today, and each of our animations will start with the float up at the top here. It's got a class name. This particular one's called b-float. It's got an animation. It's going to last for 2 seconds. It's going to ease in out infinite, which means it's going to keep running and running. That's why it keeps bouncing there. And what we're doing is we're translating, moving it around the y-axis here just a little bit to make it bounce up and down. Then we've got another little bit of code here to stop it doing it when you hover over it. There's the class name, a colon and a hover indicating a hover state, and animation play state. We've got that as pause. That's when I hover over it, it'll stop like that. Great. Well, how do you apply it to button? Couldn't be easier. Copy the class name up here. Make sure you don't take the dot. You just want the characters there, the b-float. Control C. We'll go over to my page here. I've got the builder already enabled. Take any button. You can do this on a module. It doesn't have to be on a button. But I'm going to put it in a button. And we'll change this one to a floating button. Go into your button, hit the little cog there. Over to the advanced custom CSS IDs and classes. Now remember, this is a class, not an ID, so make sure you put it in the class. Just paste the code that you've copied there, which was the float. As you can see, this one's now floating also. Once you've done that, hit save. Save the changes. And just to demonstrate, let's add this class to this module above and it'll make it float as well. Going to go into there, same place, always under advanced CSS IDs and classes. If I give it this class, it'll float also. See, that whole thing's floating. When we hover over it, it's going to stop. Not really what I want for that, but like I say, you can apply it to any row, section, or module you want, or button. So let's take that away. There we go. Now if we go back to our regular page here and I refresh this, you'll see this one that says bounce is now bouncing at the same rate as our one before. Great. Well, next up, we've got a little pulsing animation, which is this one here. If I refresh the page, you'll see that that button is going to pulse 4 times. And if we look at our code here, it's bpulse is the class name. Let's copy that one, Control C. And the keyframes, what we've got it doing is actually growing. We've got it transforming by scale, 100%, 120%, and back to 100% over a 1 second period. We've only got it doing it 4 times. So every time we refresh the page or the page loads, it's going to pulse 4 times. If you want to make it more, make it 8 times. Just do that. Publish the code and refresh the page. Our pulse should pulse 8 times now. And that's up to you. If you want to keep it going and going, just change that 8 to the word infinite. And if we publish that now and refresh, you can see that's pulsing, and that's going to continue pulsing. If you're going to do the infinite though, I would recommend you have it stop on hover. To make that happen, take the class name up here with the dot, drop down below, paste it in there with the dot, put a colon on the end, say hover, H-O-V-E-R. Then we can open and close some curly brackets and tell it to stop the animation by saying animation, colon, none. Just publish that. Now when I roll over it, it stops pulsing. I'm going to put that back to how it was. Get rid of that. And we'll change that infinite back to, I think it was 4 we had there. And obviously to make your button or module or whatever it is that you want pulse like that, copy it. Let's publish this code. Go to the page you want to work on. Let's make this module do it this time. Again, I'm just going to paste the code in there, go into the module, advanced, CSS IDs and classes, put a class name in there. As you can see, we've got that module pulsing, and it's only going to do it 4 times there because that's the iteration we've put in. Great, so that's the pulse. Let's go and look at our last one here, which is a simple bounce. Now let's just take this class name. And we'll apply it to our button that says bounce. We changed that over to something else earlier on, the float. There we go. As you can see, that's bouncing. And that's only going to bounce, I think, 4 or 5 times, whatever the iteration was that we gave it. Save our changes here and save the changes here. Go back to our custom page. If I refresh this page now, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's doing it 4 times. And you can change the count up here as usual. You can slow it down or speed it up. We've got it rolling over a 1 second period at the moment. So let's make it 3 seconds. And refresh the page. And that slowed that bounce down there. That's quite a nice little effect right there. And it's going to do it 5 times. So there you go, guys. There's 3 little fun button animations for you. Like I say, I've applied them to buttons, but you can apply them to modules, rows, whatever you want to apply them to, just by using the class names there. And all this code will be down below the video. Welcome to copy and paste it. Use it how you will. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't forget, if you have any questions, pop them below the video. I'll do my best to answer them for you or make a demo video. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.